Let me start. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Audible.
Yes,
Yeah.
sir.
So, Srikant, you can go for logging to SAP and the CRO screen. You can CRO screen, and we'll be learning the info type, the last info types specifically for Indian payroll.
Okay.
Nominations.
Yes, sir. Are you able to see my screen, sir?
Yes, I can see your screen. Just type out the employee ID.
Okay, 591, right?
Ha, 591. This is the last C info type in the Indian payroll. So there are other info types as well, but from an Indian payroll point of view, this is the last one. Again, it's very easy one also. Last one is easy one.
Okay, nomination. Yes,
Nominations.
nomination.
Okay, so nomination, why it is required?
For the regarding the ESA benefit, if the particular person has died or
Yes.
some another reason he has passed
Eligibility or
away,
not?
Yes,
so
yes.
the
Yes.
benefit will pass on to the their
Exactly.
the
Exactly.
corporate person.
So what will happen? So you are absolutely correct. Appreciate for your answer. So basically, in case of any mishappening happens for an employee, any eventuality of a death of an employee, so what will happen? The benefits due for that employee will be paid to his nominees. Okay, whoever his nominees are have been assigned, or it is also similarly we are also applicable for insurance also. If you have done any kind of insurance also, you have must have seen whether it is a health insurance or a car insurance or any kind of insurance, those things also will be there. And in terms of payroll, we have this, these are the options we do have. Okay, an employee can nominate a different beneficiary for different benefits. So we have five different types of benefits have been given here: ESI, gratuity, maternity, act, PF, pension. Okay, so it is not necessary that the same person will be nominee for all types of benefit. It is up to you again. And
Okay.
also for a different types of benefits, you can have a different CR, like 50% to someone, 50% to another one. So 50% for say wife, 50% for daughter or son. Okay, or otherwise depending upon your choice. And these subtypes are obligatory in nature. And these five subtypes we do have for this. We can start with the ESI. You can start with the PF, the most popular one. Okay. Again, so fourth one you can try. PF is because most of the people will be eligible for PF. So they generally go for. Okay. So ESI also you can try, but up to you. So you can try go for PF because that's the most everybody will be having this. PF, pension, these things. Gratuity. Okay,
Okay.
yeah, just you again, yeah, type out, go to nominee. So here you'll be entering the nominee's name. So it is a free text. You can type out anything. 0102 nominee number. Here nominee, nominee name actually, basically. Yes, correct. Nominee name, you can put it. Nominee's address, anything you can put it. Nominee's letter will be nominee's address. And the third one will be the relations. Here you enter the nominee's relationship to the employee. Okay, like it is a wife, his wife or any siblings, anything. Okay. Birth date you can put it. So in the CR, whatever you're entering, you'll be entering the percentage. Suppose you would like to enter only one. Okay, only one nominee we have, then you can put it 100%. Okay, birth date you have put somebody who is 120 years old.
1900.
Anyway, that is from
Sorry,
another point of view.
it's habituated. Sorry.
No problem, it happens. So, guardian's address you can maintain anything, any address.
Yes,
So,
sir.
what is this percentage signifies? So in case you are having single nominee, then it should be 100%. And in case you are having more than one nominees, then you have to distribute that share. Okay, suppose you are having three nominees,
Okay.
then you can put it like depending upon you, like 30, 30,
Okay.
40. Okay, that in that case, you can try. Okay, then you just save it. So this is just on data entry point of view, nothing much here. Okay, the
Okay.
nominations, only thing is, this is just for a reference. Okay, nothing much configurations much is there. Okay, That's the only thing. Okay, this is all about your nominations. Okay, so no configuration, nothing much is there. Okay, so and this is all about your Indians info types, your entire series, whatever you stand, starting with your info type 580 to till 591. Okay, so the all the 12 info types we have seen one by one. Okay, so now
yes, sir.
Any questions? So I think you have really a lot of work to do, so you have to practice all these things. Okay, so that will be seen. Other than that, what I would like to cover today, the another topic. So any questions do you have regarding this?
We have LWF, we have some ABAP issue in the server. Okay. So we haven't done that. And regarding 89, the tax relief part, we haven't understand that.
Eligibility.
Okay.
Section 89 so eligibility.
Then we can go for tax that. Rate. We can go for that because conceptually this is over. Okay, let's go to whatever the doubts we have. Okay, we'll be discussing that. 588 or 589?
88.
Sir,
88,
sir. 588.
Uh-huh.
The
fourth subject.
Tax relief part. We haven't.
It's an 89.
I have prepared. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. I have prepared the document also for that.
Okay, just show me the document.
Yeah. Okay.
And for that, you have to run the entire year's payroll. You know, so like. To get this kind of results, okay, previous financial year as well as current financial year, then you have to compare. If you have done that, then definitely you'll be getting that results. This is the perfect example actually how section 89 relief is calculated. Okay, so just calm down the scenario. If you see, you'll be able to understand. So how will you be maintaining this? Okay, so for this to build the scenario, you have to run for an employee. Just go a little bit up, I will tell you. Go a little bit up. So in the scenario, just you can replace 2015 with 2020. Okay, in your scenario, say employee till pay period with a particular salary, and you increase his salary from 1st of April 2014 on 1st of May 2015, it is saying. So what you can do, like the previous financial salary, you just change, okay, increase it from the current financial year. So in those cases, you will be finding, you'll be able to generate those specific section 89 related relief. Okay, just scroll a bit.
Okay.
So you understood the scenario, right? If this is a perfect example of how you'll be maintaining the scenario. You just follow this, okay? And then you just scroll a bit down. It will say what are the specific related to section 89. Okay, you'll be able to see here. Scroll a bit down, okay? So inside, it will be inside your INTX tax only. In the INTX.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. I've seen that /451. I'm searching for the /451, but it's not generated actually.
So
here also it's not generated.
You have done the actual payroll run or it is a simulation?
Simulation payroll, sir.
Just try to do an actual for one or two employee. Okay. Just run the previous year's payroll also. Then after that, you try to run the current financial year payroll.
Okay.
So you should be able to get that. Okay. There should not be any deviation. Just scroll a bit down. I will tell you.
Okay.
Scroll a bit down. Retroactive. This is a difference it will generate. Come down again. So how system calculates inside it. Okay. So this is the different formula inside it. Scroll a bit down again. Okay, so these are the difference. Carry forward, it will carry forward from the previous year, brought forward superannuation. So what are the different function inside this IN43 system is doing. Okay, so it will just calculate those value, and what are the different there is a difference table, okay, so which is known as the DT table. Inside that it will generate this like 6i2, 616, 622, 650 in DT table. DT table means difference table. What are the differences there? Okay, so those it will just compare the original value with the change value. Okay, so again it will be updated and it will be moved them into the current year. Okay, so for that you should have a payroll for the previous year financial year as well. Okay, otherwise what you can do, you can hire employee from 2018-19. Okay, so then you maintain some amount, maintain those value for those run the payroll, then in the current financial year again you try to change certain things in the previous financial year. Okay, as they have been mentioned in this particular detailed document. Okay, then you again run the payroll. Okay, so if you follow this document now, so you will be definitely able to achieve what you want to do. Okay, related to success. This is very nice document. It is prepared by the SAP product team itself. They themselves already prepared it. So it is very much, and you will be finding this difference table, and in the output is, so you will be seeing all this class 6i2, 616, 622, 650. Okay, so these are the difference the table. System will generate those specific values, okay, and then it will push those value into the DT table, which is nothing but your difference table. Okay, so after this calculation is done, just scroll a bit down again, I will tell you.
Okay.
Even today also I refer this sometimes, suppose I am faced some challenges, then I always refer this, and this is how the calculation will happen. Suppose if you go inside the INTAX, okay, the system will tell this kind of calculation with very detailed values. Okay, so recently I also got an incident for it. Okay, so like the person was having some issue in the previous year financial year, and I referred this and I had to do this calculation. Then his CA, the chartered accountant, because while tax filing he was asking like why this value is coming, how it is derived from SAP. So basically the customer wanted to mean, because he is not aware of how to check it inside the end user will not be knowing the, all these things if he is not expert in payroll. So I have to go through this this payroll period, and I have to go to this INTAX processing. And after that, what I did, I took this entire screenshot, and also I prepared this calculation in an Excel sheet as well. Okay, because this is also sometimes misleading. Suppose somebody will not be understanding what is I year, what is F year, okay, current year, your current financial year. So all these details actually I prepared an Excel sheet. And also along with that, I just attach the screenshot from how it is system calculates all these things. Okay, then you just scroll a bit down, I will tell you.
Okay, sir.
So what does it say? So how this calculation is happening is, okay, so if you go to, so what does it say? Section 89 switch, that means one, it is, what does it mean? If it is one, that means system will calculate your section 89 relief. Okay, so that is the standard one, and some of the difference in tax with and without area for previous year. So what this is known as a delta tax. So what is the delta tax? Okay, so difference in tax. So what, how will you understand this? So for that, so here you can see there is an amount 1,65,244. Okay, so this is a tax with arrears. Suppose you are having arrears for that particular financial year, then this is the tax. And suppose we are not having the arrear, there will be a particular amount of tax. That the difference, so what is the difference? So there is a difference of 61,357. Okay, so this is known as a delta tax. Suppose if you have, let's say, Srikanth has received a bonus from the previous financial year, but he is paid in the current financial year. Okay. Suppose you have not been paid that amount in that particular financial year, previous financial year, what should be the tax? Okay, that is known as tax without arrear. Okay, so there is something called tax with arrear, then is it something called tax without arrear. Okay, so that is the difference between, is known as a delta tax for the current year. Similarly, there will be delta for if there is anything for the previous year as well. Okay, so system, what it will do, system will just add, keep on adding those, some of the differences. Okay, so from the current year, from the previous year, okay, then that amount will be getting relaxed, okay? Or we call it a Section 89 relief, because this is not the fault of you or the employee. the employer actually has given that particular amount in the current financial year, which they should have paid in the last financial year, so that the tax amount would be lesser. Okay, as you are paid in the current financial year, your tax is more. Okay, so to reduce those kind of activities or to change this thing, okay, system has this provision to calculate, which is known as the Section 89 relief. Okay, so this is the amount it has been generated from the system. So depending upon this calculation only, okay, so this is one of the most important one, but again, not very frequently will be coming across. Once in a while you'll be getting this kind of issues, okay, but this is very important to understand the concept, okay, the Section 89 relief. And this blog is more than enough. Even today also, if some doubt I do have, I always refer this particular blog. Okay. So this is very helpful. And you should be able to generate the way it has been guided here in this particular wiki. And you should be able to generate this. So this is a task for you. You have to see so many this kind of calculation in your system. Okay. After doing that, and I recommend just run this actual payroll run. Do not do any simulation. Okay. For the previous financial year. Okay, for the current financial year, you can do simulation, but at least for the previous financial year, you must have done the actual payroll run. Then only you'll be able to see all these things. Okay, then let me know if you have any using challenge. And you got the idea, like how to do it?
Yes, sir. I got the clear idea.
You understood, Lakshmi, yes, what I have tried to say? You understood?
Yes, sir. I understood.
So now you go back to the main page of this wiki. I have certain tasks for you again. So did you guys sign off for that SCN, Asset Community Network, which I told you earlier?
Actually, I have previously signed that, but I haven't found the which is my user ID. I'm
okay
for that, actually. Okay.
What about you, Lakshmi? Did you try that?
I asked to Kanti, sir. But...
Okay.
Designer.
Yeah, we will do, sir. We will do. Actually, we are more focused on the which you have given the tasks.
Task. Okay. Okay. No problem. Yes, so this is the further thing. Okay. So this is the next level. Level 3, I will say. Okay. Currently, we are doing in level 2. Okay. Learning. So that is the level 3 learning, I will say. And level 4 will be your once you get deployed into a project. Once you get your job and so go to that particular only main page, there is a Confluence Mobile is written. Okay. You can bookmark this thing so that you do not have to forget. Okay. I don't think this is the one.
So dashboard or which
one? Dashboard, go there, dashboard. I think this is, looks like a mobile version. Just go to the desktop version.
Okay.
Click there and go to the switch to desktop version. There is a, just come down. Come down. Switch to desktop version.
Okay.
So from here, you can go to the spaces.
Yeah. Okay.
Space directory. Here, otherwise, you can go to HCM. Is there anything has come down?
Okay, sir.
Human Capital Management, ERP Human Capital Management.
ERP Human Capital Management, okay.
Now you can save this as your favorite. Okay, so from here, you can refer. Okay, I do always this thing. I always kept it. So now you can come down, then there will be specific page for your payroll. Okay, so this covers everything, even success factor is there, but very limited one. So what I will recommend to go payroll version, just go to the payroll versions, come down. There is something called payroll and your APJ, I think it would come under APJ only. Go to APJ.
Okay.
APJ, I think it's, then it is kept under MENA. Just go to the MENA, go back again.
Okay.
The Asia Pacific Japan, it is the different one. Then EMEA. Okay. India. Hmm. Indian payroll is only one of the payroll which is well documented, I have seen. And just go to the getting started again. Yeah. So this, all of the tasks, whatever has been given here. Okay. So there are many new things also there.
Already seen.
Okay. So you can see whatever we have covered already, right? Regarding Section 80, 581. So for professional tax, there is a thing. Professional tax, there are so many blocks you can see. P-tax is your professional tax only. Okay. These concepts are already explained with the practical examples, actually, which we want to try to understand. Those things are also there here. Okay. Similarly, there are some specific topics like car and conveyance, how the calculation of HRA exam is happening in the INHRA. Okay. So all these details have been created by the SAP product team. So in the created by options, whatever you are seeing, these are all people from SAP. Okay. So the SAP product team have actually created all these documents. Okay. So you can always refer these documents, okay, these blogs, which will be after you do whatever hands-on I have given, okay. Then it will always be helpful. This is the way you will be learning all these things. And some of the things can be also outdated, okay. So you can see there is a line item called income tax surcharge calculation since 2013-14. I think it's still working, but some of the documents, more 99% of the documents are very active and they are relevant today's also, okay. So most of the things will be surely working. You can go for this. Okay. So for this, then we will be proceeding further. Okay. So in the next session, what we'll be doing. Okay. So yes, these are already done. So you keep on practicing. Okay. And maybe in the next session, we'll be starting with the your schema, payroll, all this part. Okay. And then again, after covering those things, and we'll be doing a quick recap. Whatever you have already understood related to waste type, permissibility and things, one or two sessions we'll be taking on that. And similarly, we'll be having one session specifically for how to take those requirement consulting part, like how in the typical implementation, how we'll be interacting with the client, what are the things we'll be asking them. Okay, that with the business, how to, what is the business blueprint? Okay, all those project specific things I'll be covering. Okay. So then we will keep on. So let me check. So almost 60% is over now. Okay, 50-60%.
Okay, sir.
So let's go for schema function PCRs. We'll be seeing focusing on it because these are the most complicated topic. Okay, we'll go there and we'll try to understand those things. And I'll be also sharing with some real time scenarios which you'll be doing. And also, I'll be, those are really guide, those kind of configuration will be kind of a guided implement. I'll be guiding you. And you'll be doing those configurations in your system, then we'll be verifying those things. Okay. So in this way, we'll be proceeding. So.